classic Alfa Romeo V6 engine, nicknamed Busso from his creator's name, is so revered among enthusiasts that its presence under any Alfa's bonnet multiplies the car's market value. Why? Well, just listen to it. This story starts at the end of the 1960s, when Alfa Romeo was riding high on the Giulia's success. With the larger Alfetta and Alfa 6 on the drawing board, a new, larger engine was needed for the future. Giuseppe Busso designed a compact, lightweight V6 engine, whose cylinder head design was a complete departure from previous Alfa practice. The two valves per cylinder were at a much tighter angle between them to reduce thermal losses and increase efficiency. The single, belt-driven camshaft per bank operated the intake valves, while the exhaust valves were conducted by a rocker via a short push rod. Although the first V6 prototypes started testing in 1968, the world wouldn't get to hear Arese's violin for another decade. As the 1973 oil crisis hit the small, financially weak Alfa Romeo like a wrecking ball, the launch of the Alfa 6 got delayed until 1979, together with the 2.5-liter V6 designed for it. Although the choice of six carburetors for the Alfa 6 engine may seem puzzling, no fuel injection system available at the time could yet manage individual throttle bodies. Busso and the other Alfa engineers were justifiably proud of their lusty engines and did not want to compromise the throttle response and drivability they wanted. 1983 saw the introduction of a downsized 2-liter version of the V6 engine in an attempt to increase its sales potential on the Italian market. Meanwhile, in South Africa, Alfa Romeo built a limited run of 200 GT V6s, equipped with a carbureted V6 enlarged to 3 liters to compete in the local Touring Car Championship. 1980 saw the Busso V6 appear under the bonnet of the restyled Alfetta GT. The GT V6, thanks to the smooth power of its fuel-injected 2.5-liter engine, soon became every car enthusiast's darling, with its attractive combination of style, practicality and performance. The same engine went into the 75 in 1985. 1986 saw the introduction of the 92-liter V6, equipped with Alfa Romeo's own electronic fuel injection system, the Controllo Elettronico Motore. Available exclusively on the Italian market, only around 1500 such cars were sold. The 3-liter V6 made mainstream Alfa Romeo production in February 1987, when the Alfa 75 3-liter V6 America was introduced, while Alfa's new front-wheel drive flagship, the 164, was presented in September of the same year. To fit it under the 164's bonnet line, Alfa Romeo redesigned the engine's intake, moving the throttle body and plenum chamber towards the firewall. And that's how those sexy, shiny inlet ducts were born. This 192-horsepower V6 would live on until 1998 under the 916 Spider's bonnet, while the 164 switched to the newer 24-valve version from 1992. The same year, a detuned Busso 3-liter V6 found its way under the hood of the Lancia Tema. The most powerful production version of the 12-valve 3-liter Busso V6 was the one fitted to a very special Alfa Romeo. The engine used on the SZ derived from the unit used on the 75, with a higher compression ratio and a sharper cam profile to boost power up to 210 horsepower. At this point, we shall not forget that the 3-liter V6 did not spell the end of the 2.5-liter one, which returned for 1992 to power the front wheels of the newly launched 155 Saloon. With Italian taxation penalizing engines over 2 liters of capacity, the 164 V6 was a forbidden fruit for many Italian Alfisti. Given over 50% of all Alfa Romeos were sold below the Alps, it's easy to see why the company presented the 164 V6 Turbo in 1991. While the exhaust note couldn't match the glorious wail of the 3 liters unit, the 2 liters turbocharged cars often proved faster in real-world driving conditions. Very popular on the 164 and then on the GTV Coupé, this punchy little beast of an engine was briefly offered on the 166 as well, before being discontinued upon the arrival of Euro 3 anti-pollution regulations. The most significant chapter in the Alfa Romeo V6 engine's evolution has certainly been the adoption of 4 valves per cylinder in 1992. The new cylinder heads were designed according to the latest trends in technology. The 4 valves per cylinder were now directly operated by 2 belt-driven camshafts per each bank. Ignition cables were gone and replaced by a direct ignition system with a coil per each spark plug. Those plugs, to reduce maintenance cost, were higher quality items with platinum inserts, expected to last 100,000 km. Although the unit fitted to the Proteo concept car of 1991 packed a claimed 260 horsepower, the production engine's output ranged from the 204 horsepower on the Lancia K to the 232 seen on the range-topping 164 Quadrifoglio Verde and the later Q4. 1997 saw the debut of one of Alfa Romeo's greatest commercial successes, the stunningly beautiful 156, whose range-topping model came equipped with a sweet 2.5 V6 engine, which packed 190 horsepower thanks to the new 24-valve cylinder heads. The Busso 3-liter V6 was also briefly available on the unsuccessful Lancia Thesis. Automobile production at the historic site of Arese ended in 2000, leaving the Busso V6 production line as the last remaining activity in the old factory, a place whose fate had already been decided by Fiat's top brasses. For the embattled Italian conglomerate, the Milanese V6 was now a residual program. Until the 156 GTA program gave the Alfa V6 a chance for a last hurrah. The increment in displacement was achieved through a new crankshaft with a longer stroke, while the cylinder's bore remained unchanged. The final batch of engines was built on the 31st of December 2005, and, in a sad but rather fitting coincidence, Giuseppe Busso died aged 92 just a few days later, on the 3rd of January 2006.